do a search. Sound of rain. Oh, these recordings help you go to sleep, right? Relaxing, peaceful rain sounds, pitter-patter. That's your ordinary rainstorm. But what about those storms that are on the next level of intensity? Rain pouring down, thundering booms and flashing lights streaking down across the sky. From that description, you might have a good idea of the natural wonder we're talking about today. That's right, thunderstorms. I hope you're ready to get a little wet, because we're about to take the plunge into these rainy events. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Did you ever make up a story to explain what was going on in a loud, scary storm? You're not alone. Scandinavian mythology tells us about Thor, the god of thunder, hurling lightning bolts at his enemies and making a racket by swinging his mighty hammer. The ancient Greeks thought Zeus, the king of the gods, used a thunderbolt as a weapon, and so they made a shrine in places where lightning struck. And Native Americans thought that lightning came from a magical bird flashing its eyes, and whose flapping wings caused thunder. They called it Thunderbird, a powerful name we still use to this day when we want to invoke supernatural strength. A thunderstorm, also known as an electrical storm or a lightning storm, is a type of storm that includes thunder and lightning. It happens when the air high up is much cooler than the warm, moist air near the ground. When this warm air goes up into the cool air quickly, it creates big, tall clouds called cumulonimbus clouds. That word is almost as big and scary as the clouds themselves. Let's take a closer look. Cumulonimbus. This word comes from the Latin cumulus, which means swell, like accumulate, and nimbus, which means cloud. So now this big word makes a lot of sense. An accumulation of clouds. These cumulonimbus clouds can get very tall, which also means they get extremely powerful. But there's more than these big, tall clouds involved. Thunderstorms need three main things to form. Moisture to make clouds and rain, warm air that rises because it's lighter than cool air, and something that helps push the air up, like a hill or a front. Now, that's a word weather reporters love to use. A front is where warm and cool air meet. When these conditions are just right, the storm can bring lots of rain, gusty winds, and sometimes hail or even tornadoes, along with the lightning and thunder. Because we can hear and see thunder and lightning, that's what we really associate with a thunderstorm. Lightning happens when electrical charges build up in a storm cloud. Positive charges often gather at the top of the cloud, while the negative charges build up at the bottom. When the difference between these charges becomes too big, a spark of electricity, or lightning, shoots out to balance them. This lightning can travel between clouds, which is called cloud-to-cloud lightning, or from a cloud to the ground, known as cloud-to-ground lightning. Did you know there were different kinds of lightning? There are more, but let's focus on the lightning involved in thunderstorms. When lightning flashes, it heats the air around it very quickly. This hot air expands rapidly, creating a sound wave that we hear as thunder. Because light travels faster than sound, we usually see the lightning before we hear the thunder. So, by counting the seconds between seeing lightning and hearing thunder, we can estimate how far away the storm is. 1 hippopotamus, 2 hippopotamus, 3 hippopotamus. That storm is about 1 kilometer away. Want to take home a souvenir of these natural wonders? Visit our website for smart fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. Thunderstorms come in different types, each with unique features. First, we have single-cell thunderstorms, which are small and usually don't last long. They form in places with low wind and can cause short, heavy rain and some lightning. Next, there are multi-cell thunderstorms. These are groups of thunderstorms that move together, each storm at a different stage of life, which makes the whole cluster last longer than any single storm within it. Multi-cell thunderstorms all look a little bit different, but some can form a long line that can stretch for miles and bring intense wind and heavy rain to a wide area. Lastly, the most powerful type, supercells, are highly organized storms featuring a rotating updraft called a mesocyclone. Supercells cause the most dangerous and extreme weather. In some cases, they even produce hail and tornadoes. Each type of thunderstorm has its own unique way of impacting the environment and weather around it. These thunderstorm types are different, but it's like they're all from the same family. They all form in a similar way. There are three main stages that thunderstorms go through as they begin and end. The first stage is called the developing stage. This is when warm, moist air starts to rise into the cooler air above and begins to form cumulus clouds. These clouds look fluffy and grow as more warm air pushes up. As the cloud gets bigger and taller, it enters the second stage, known as the mature stage. This is the most active time for the thunderstorm. The cloud has grown so tall that it starts to look like an anvil at the top. During this stage, the storm releases most of its rain, lightning, and thunder. After the storm has used up most of its energy, it enters the final stage, the dissipating stage. During this time, the updrafts of warm air weaken, the storm loses its intensity, and the rain starts to lighten up. Eventually, the cloud breaks apart and the thunderstorm ends. At least they don't last forever, right? Mother Nature should be satisfied with this level of chaos, right? Wrong. She doesn't let up. Thunderstorms can actually lead to more damage with other kinds of natural phenomena. The intense energy and rising air in thunderstorms can lead to the formation of tornadoes. The strong winds of thunderstorms flow in all different directions, and when they start to spin around each other, it leads to tornadoes. And as if intense rain and wind weren't enough, under the right conditions, thunderstorms can also produce hail. This happens when updrafts push raindrops upward towards the very cold areas of the storm. Here, the raindrops freeze into little raindrop pellets, also known as hail. And when we say little pellets, keep in mind hail can sometimes get golf ball sized. Ouch. If you're interested in learning more about other painful natural wonders like these, be sure to check out the rest of our video series, linked below. Between the lightning and the winds and the hail, you can see that staying safe during a thunderstorm is very important, whether you're at home or outside. If you're outdoors and a storm begins, find shelter immediately. If you're at home, stay inside and away from windows, doors, and anything that conducts electricity, like corded phones and appliances. It's also a good idea to avoid taking baths or showers during a thunderstorm, as plumbing can conduct electricity from a lightning strike. Remember, if you can hear thunder, you're close enough to be struck by lightning. So, as soon as you hear it, head to safety and wait until 30 minutes after the last clap of thunder before going back outside. The next time you're stuck inside because of a booming thunderstorm, you can look out at the pouring rain with a new perspective. You can watch the flashes in the sky and remember why lightning happens. You can hear the roar of thunder and understand how the sound is made. And of course, maybe most important of all, you will know how to keep yourself and your family safe until the storm passes. And they always do. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.